I, Charles, take you, Ashley, to be my wife.
I, Ashley, take you, Charles, to be my husband.
I declare that they are husband and wife in accordance with the laws of God and the ordinances of Bermuda. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Charles, you may kiss your wife.
Ashley and I met September of 2004 at the Young Adult Ministry meeting at Alfred Street Baptist Church. It was after the meeting and we were socializing as a group, and she just came up and introduced herself as she had met me a long time ago during Sunday school class.
There's two stories. If you ask him, he'll tell you we met at a young adult ministry activity at our church. Ask me or my mom will tell you that we met in Sunday school when we were probably 7 or 8 years old at the same church that we go to now. So we probably met in Sunday school, at least that would be my age. The first time that I met Charles in Sunday school, at least my mom tells me that I used to come home from Sunday school and tell her about Charles and Cherie, his sister. Charles and Cherie, they said such and such and such and such. And that was every Sunday after Sunday.
And of course, I don't remember the class and meeting her before. But that's when we first met and began. First impressions when we met a second time would have been bowling, again with the young adult ministry. Of course, she's got plenty of personality, so my first thought was, she's crazy. She's a lot of fun. We talked more that night, and that led to, I guess, the next sequence of dates.
First impression in our most recent meeting, I was with a girlfriend of mine who was friends with some of his friends, and we were standing there and we were talking, and I didn't say anything to him at first because, you know, I felt like, I don't know, I probably shouldn't say anything. But then I went ahead and said hi. His first response to that was a look like, oh, who is this crazy person? So, I said hi, you know, I'm a friend of Kim's, and I think I knew you from a long time ago. We had Sunday school together right up there on the stage. His face looked like sheer panic. And then, of course, when my girlfriend and I walked away, I said, you know, he's a jerk. I never want to talk to him. Our second meeting was at another young adult ministry activity, with bowling that evening. When I'd seen him, and in my head, I was thinking, don't say anything to him. Walk past him, just act like you didn't see him, because the first time you met him, he was a jerk. Something made me say hi. We ended up talking and bowling with the
first time. We formally call it a date, but we came here to the World War II Memorial. It was just an afternoon, spent time walking around, taking pictures, just more of a conversation type date. We just spent the day out here at the memorial. At first, for the first few months, it was just like we were friends. We just had enjoyed each other's company, had great conversation, always had somewhere we wanted to go in common. And so that was just the first, you know, 4 or 5 months, having no idea that we would get this far.
We'll live in love forever, yeah. Girl, we'll be alone, you and me. We'll spend our lives together, together.
We started sitting together maybe 2 years into our relationship.
Probably for the first year, so you know the normal Alpha Street gossip wouldn't occur. It was a secret, so we avoided sitting together. People had an idea, people knew, but it wasn't really discussed, and so we sat apart.
If you ask Charles who said "I love you" first, they'd probably say "I did," but I don't think that's right. I think he did first.
I'm gonna say it was her. I don't recall the first time I said it. But I'm going to say it was her. I proposed to Ashley February of this year. It was Valentine's Day. I had made up my mind probably a couple months prior to that. We ended up going out to dinner here in D.C. It was cold. It had snowed that day. I was trying to postpone the dinner because I knew what I was trying to do. She did not want to give up her Valentine's Day dinner. And so she forced us to come out, but it was a good time. We went to dinner, came back to the memorial. She says it wasn't a surprise. I mean, she wasn't suspect of anything. When we came back down here, we walked briefly, but it was very cold. So we ended up going back into the car. We talking about reminiscing about our first dates here, and experiences we had in between. And then when I formally proposed, we were actually sitting in the car looking at the World War II.
On Valentine's Day, which I was totally on. It was a surprise. The past year or two, we talked about getting married, and he'd always said, never do it on Valentine's Day, because that's the day of love when people are forced into buying chocolate for women. We went out to dinner, which was a surprise. He picked an Italian restaurant, which is my favorite, in D.C. We were on our way back from dinner, he made this sharp right turn into the World War II Memorial. He's like, hey, look, the lights are on. The water's all pretty. And we were sitting there in the car because it was freezing and it snowed. We started talking about our relationship. And then he asked if I wanted to get in the car. And I said, no. I said, it's cold outside. I have a skirt on. Continued talking, and I said, oh, I have your Valentine's Day gift. And I jumped out of the car to go get it, which apparently played all into his plan. I am such a goofball. Normally, I give two cards for every occasion, one that's kind of funny and one that's serious. He read his funny card, and his serious card was actually from his birthday that I'd forgotten to give to him. But it really talked about how happy I was with our relationship, and that he was the person that I wanted to be with. And then, of course, it moved into him wanting to give me my gift and ask me to close my eyes. So I sat there and put it on my lap. And when I opened it, honestly, it sounded like birds chirping everywhere. And people say that. And it's so cliche, but, you know, you're just in a daze. So it was a nice moment. I did. But I actually asked him if he asked my dad first. And then he said, yes, I asked your dad. Now, will you answer the question? Oh, yes, yeah.
It was funny. Her immediate reaction was definitely shock. She was screaming. But her first question was, did I ask her dad? And then once she got over that point, she responded affirmative, and it's been a memory ever since.
You know, we called the first official one to the World War II Memorial.
Charles is telling me all his childhood stories. They were good ones. What? You were! You were! They were good! I thought you were cute! He has a sense of humor that sort of beams all over the place. He makes me laugh. So the majority of the day we spent talking and laughing. It's kind of like old friends.
The qualities I enjoy about Ashley is one, our ability to have a good conversation, talk. We laugh, which is important to me. So whether she laughs at my jokes or has the ability to make me laugh. So that was what was
whether
important.
Whether you travel or just things on your top 50 list of things you want to do in life. And a lot of ours are similar, so just doing those, taking it day by day, and really enjoying life.
And I agree. You know, you never know where you'll end up, but, you know, we're just trying to. We have plans, and we'll see if we follow them and get there. So we'll see. We'll see. As long as we're together.
Yeah. I like him. I'll keep him.
Thank you. that a star would guide you my way to share with me this special day. Well, ribbons in the sky for our love. If allowed, may I touch your hand? And if please, may I once again, so that you too will understand, there's a ribbon in the sky. Is a ribbon in the sky for our love. Love we can lose. With God on our side, we'll find strength in each tear we cry. From now on, it will be you and I. And our
this day.